She stands here today to deliver a speech on hijab. ये लड़की हिजाब पर स्पीच देने जा रही है तो ये सिर्फ बोल नहीं रही है ये अमल भी कर रही है और ये इनके डैडी ने कहा मैंने कभी इनको ऐसा स्ट्रिक्टली बताया नहीं कि हिजाब करना है आपने ये फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड से अपना चेहरा छुपाती है और पढ़ाई में भी गज़ब बहुत अच्छा और शी इज़ हियर टुडे टू डिलीवर ए स्पीच ऑन हिजाब इट्स नॉट अ स्पीच बट इट्स अ मैसेज फॉर द एंटायर ह्यूमैनिटी एंड द एंटायर वर्ल्ड
Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to all of you. I am Hiba Sultana. I am a student. I have completed my 10th standard at IPS International Islamic Public School International, Hyderabad. Ladies and gentlemen, with immense sincerity, I stand here of the days to deliver a speech on hijab. And I am sure through India Islamic Cultural Center, through this iconic platform, My message on hijab, my love for hijab, my respect for hijab, my emotions attached with hijab will spread across the world, inshallah. A woman modestly dressed is like a pearl in its shell. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran that, O Prophet, tell your wives and daughters and the women of the believers to draw their veils over their bodies when they step out of their houses. That is most convenient that they could be known. A such decent woman and not be teased. Now you all tell me, if a room is full of cheap white marbles, and if there's also one that is pure and red, sure enough, it needs a jewel box for its protection. So if I am that pure and red marble, my hijab is that jewel box that protects me. Hijab does not cover up a girl's beauty, but in fact, it displays her strength, commitment, and confidence, which is built out of love for her Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not for the love of this worldly life. Some people claim that wearing hijab is going back to the prehistoric period. Well, that's not true. Such people fail to realize that actually being half naked is going back to the Stone Age. Very often this question arises that why do Muslim women wear hijab? Let me answer this question to the world that the beauty of a woman is for their husbands, their man, and not for the mankind. Dear sisters, when your hijab is seen through, or when the scarf on your head is covered but your hair is showing, or when your hair is covered but your ears are showing, or when both your head and hair are fully covered but you're flaunting your body with skin-tight clothes and still think that you're wearing hijab, then my dear sisters, you're truly mistaken. That is not hijab. That really is not your hijab. You know what hijab is? Hijab is an act of obedience to the Creator, an act of submission to the Lord, an act of honor and dignity, an act of simplicity and purity. It means modesty for all in all forms, and of course, freedom from evil eyes. Dear sisters, even though a man is responsible for his gaze, you too are responsible for what you give him to gaze at. So guard your modesty. Dear brothers, coming to you, where is your hijab? Where is your iman? Why do you look from woman to woman instead of lowering your gaze? One should know that Islam treats both men and women equally. And don't forget that hijab was first made compulsion for men before women. All the religious scriptures talk of women covering themselves, as the Bible says that women should be dressed with severity. It is also mentioned that a woman who does not cover her hair should be shaved off. Haven't you seen the images of Mother Teresa covering her head? Haven't you seen the images of Mother Mary, Mother of Jesus, covering her head? It is mentioned in the Vedas too that women should cover their heads. And the Quran says that modesty is the crown of a lady. I wrap up my speech with a beautiful poem. You look at me and you call me oppressed simply because of the way I'm dressed. You know me not for what's inside. You judge the clothing I wear with pride. I am an individual, I'm no man's slave. It's Allah's pleasure that I only crave. I have a voice, so I will be heard. For in my heart, I carry His word. Man doesn't tell me to dress this way. It's a law from God that I obey. Oppressed is something I'm truly not. For liberation is what I have got. I can climb mountains, across the seas, expand my mind in all degrees. For God Himself gave us the liberty when He sent Islam to you and me. I'm immensely grateful to India Islamic Cultural Center and English House Academy for providing me with this splendid opportunity to address you all wonderful trainees of this famous personality development workshop. I'm equally thankful to my father who has booked flight tickets from Hyderabad to Delhi and brought me here with my mother and little sister to motivate me and help me explore myself. Let me take this opportunity to inform you all that very recently I have underwent a one-month personality development workshop at Metropolis Hotel, Secunderabad in Telangana, where school children, college students, graduates, postgraduates, teachers, lecturers, doctors, engineers, advocates, businessmen and ulama from 11 different states of India took the training. And believe me, it was a great experience learning the importance of communication skills and values of life with the trainees from all walks of life. And icing on the cake, learning such important things by the one and only renowned international trainer, Munawar Zama, sir. Having seen the teachers, lecturers, doctors, engineers, advocates, I initially thought that I was a small fish in a big ocean. And I was totally afraid that how I could compete with the sharks of the ocean. But the continuous motivational lectures and pep talks of Zama sir made me capable and confident to compete with the sharks and outperform them. And my happiness knew no bounds on the day to learn that Zama sir acknowledged me with an award named Gem of the Workshop. I would like to tell you all that here in this ongoing training workshop, everybody has equal opportunity to excel. Any student from Hindi medium background can outshine the students of convent schools or the student of any international school, as this is the beauty of the training imparted by Zama sir. I wish you all the very best of luck for the workshop and extend my thanks again to India Islamic Cultural Center for giving opportunity to aspirants like me. India Islamic Cultural Center is a wonderful place. I wish the president of India Islamic Cultural Center, Sirajuddin Qureshi sir, to establish the same in Hyderabad, where thousands of aspirants like me can fulfill their dreams and accomplish their goals. Thank you so much for listening to me and have a wonderful day.
Such a wonderful performance by a girl who observes, who practices hijab. Otherwise, our community, parents, ye sab bolte hain ki ye hijab mein hai, ye kahin ja nahi sakti hai, ye seekh nahi sakti hai, ye muqabla nahi kar sakti hai. She competed, a school girl competed with MA teachers, lecturers, doctors, engineers. And on the day of convocation, we had a competition among the participants. She participated, she competed, and she got the award that is gem of the workshop. I believe she could reach the hearts of young girls, and the world would definitely seek inspiration from this speech and practice hijab.